Kareem, it's always the network's fault. I'm hoping you've got something that helps me better manage and perhaps preempt issues, maybe got some AI to help me not always be the person that's blamed.
Absolutely, with our ENNA, our network assurance certification that we are releasing towards the end of May, you'll be able to actually certify and know these knowledge exactly what you did, which is the core component of Thousand Eyes being involved in the certification, where you can deploy different agents in the different spots, whether that's on-prem, in your enterprise network or in the cloud or at an ISP level itself. You can actually pinpoint where sometimes it's not the network's fault.
Yeah, I'd say more often than not.
Yes.
It's what I hope, really.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey everyone, it's David Bumble coming to you from Cisco Live, back with Kareem. Kareem, welcome.
Hey, thanks for having me.
So Kareem, we last spoke in Vegas, I believe it was.
Right, last year, Vegas.
That's right. I believe there's changes since then. In Vegas, we learned about some new certifications, but they were still on the horizon. Can you give us an update?
Yeah, so last time we talked about this, we were releasing our enterprise network cloud connectivity certification. We were working on our cloud security certification at a specialist level, and we have those out today. They are there to test you and the market on knowing your cloud connectivity. We know that your traditional network engineer does not typically have just an on-prem presence nowadays. You got to understand the cloud. And so we want to make sure that the market has that skill set to accomplish what we need them to accomplish. And so we cover things in the enterprise network, in ENCC. We cover things around connecting your branch, your on-site with VEdge over an SD-WAN overlay, connecting out to your AWS instance or your Azure or whatever flavor of cloud you have.
I was going to ask you, is it only like one cloud, but it's a whole bunch, right?
Yeah, it's the giant three. We expect you to understand, you know, things like VPCs, you know, subnetting, all of that. But again, your skill set as a network engineer hasn't really changed. You know, this happens a lot where I talk to customers and they're like, well, what do I need to do? Like, I'm a network engineer. The cloud is happening. Is my job going away?
Exactly. Yeah.
And I'm sure.
Yeah. All the time.
All the time. Right. But really it's just morphed, right? The same skill sets, you still need to understand subnetting. You still need to understand how to create a VPC,
yeah,
which are all pieces, components to the cloud, but they're still core network engineering.
How's it different to like just getting an AWS cert? Like I could go and get an AWS cert on Azure cert. How's the Cisco certs different?
So this is more focused on the Cisco side of things as opposed to the cloud portion.
Yeah.
So what we're testing or what we're asking you to learn is essentially, what is it that I need to do on my on-prem? How do I extend that portion using SD-WAN solution out to the cloud? So we're focused on deploying the SD-WAN, on designing the SD-WAN architecture for your network, putting vManage in, expanding out over an SD-WAN overlay. So all these components are kind of the focus for that specialist certification. And then while we're at it, we understand that security is huge.
I was going to ask you, it's a big problem, right?
So this is why we came up with the Secure the Cloud certification itself, because now that you're opening yourself up, right, out to the cloud, you got to understand how to make that pipeline more secure. And so this is part of our secure the cloud's CAST certification.
So there's, just give me the names again, just for everyone. It's the...
So you've got ENCC,
yep,
which is Cloud Connect.
Yep.
You've got SCAST, which is our secure the cloud certification. And then we just recently released our ENNA or Enterprise Network Assurance.
Yeah, that was released like just a few weeks ago,
the
right?
The blueprint just got released a couple of weeks ago, and the exam is going to be released towards the end of May, and with training on Cisco U. But now that we have kind of a on-prem and in the cloud, you want to be able to see your network end to end and make sure that observability is available and you can hone in on the issues, because now you have a greater playing field, right? And so with ENNA, we incorporated things like Cisco Thousand Eyes,
yep,
right? Where we teach you how to configure agents at the different endpoints on the cloud and on-prem and aggregate all this data. You know, we talk about AI, David, and this is a hot topic,
yep,
right? Cisco's been doing machine learning for a long time.
Yeah, people, right? Forget that.
And so the reason why we have observability today is because in the Cisco product, we have AI. We have AI in our Catalyst center from assurance perspective. We have AI in Thousand Eyes. And so all of this data is being pumped into different products with machine learning on top of it. It allows us to pinpoint the issues and the traffic issues that you have from your cloud to your on-prem.
So I want to ask you two things. Firstly, question or complaint a lot of people have is Cisco releases cert, but how do I get training? Is it just a blueprint or is it training on Cisco U or somewhere?
So we talked about, touched a little bit on this when we were starting off the whole Cisco U initiative and the platform. So what we've done is we know it's hard to get a certification because content is everywhere.
Yeah.
So what we're doing now is once we release our certification and blueprint, we follow it with the official training for that certification. And not only this, but we actually provide our learners a way for them to test out that learning by giving the first track of every new certification learning path in Cisco U. So right now, actually, if you head to u.cisco.com, you could actually take the Secure the Cloud learning path, the first track for free of charge with your free CCO.
But I mean, the point is all the content's on Cisco U at the moment, or is it still coming for these tracks?
ENCC is on Cisco U. SCAST is being built. First track is on Cisco U today.
Okay.
ENNA is coming with the certification once we release it in May. I think the in June or July, the training is going to follow suit.
Oh, that's great.
We also know that there are things around the certification that you need to understand, like SD-WAN is a hot thing, right?
Yeah, exactly.
If you've never done anything with SD-WAN, today we actually have a promo as part of the RevUp to ReCert campaign.
You got to tell us about that because, I mean, people don't know about it. Yeah. It's fantastic, right?
I'm excited about this because this is something that made a lot of sense.
It's not just for this, but it's for different things. So give us a rundown about what it's about.
So RevUp to ReCert is we release it every other month. It's essentially a campaign that we release to allow you to get into Cisco U, take a free learning path that will give you CE, continue education credit you to ReCert. Free of charge, you have a window of 30 to 40 days, typically it's 30 days, to accomplish that learning path. And then it automatically gets attached to your account and you can ReCert using those CE credits.
And I mean, you guys keep releasing these things. So if I keep on top of things, I'm getting free training.
Exactly. And they're relevant to the certs that we release too, right? So right now, if you go on Cisco U, you can actually take the SD-WAN fundamentals as part of the research, RevUp to ReCert.
And then
get ready for ENCC and as well as recertify.
Do you want to talk about the blueprint for the new cert or is there anything you want to highlight?
No. So it actually, one of the great thing about this blueprint is, As a tech geek, it makes a lot of logical sense to me, right? So like one of the things that we wanted to, as we look at the blueprint, is to look at the architecture of, think about it from a network assurance perspective, right? You have, with network assurance in general, is you have different components throughout your stack. And so we want to make sure that you know how the architecture works. And then we want to test you on how to deploy the different agents and configure those from a Thousand Eyes perspective. And then these agents collect data. So we want to be able to see how you can aggregate that data and do something with it. And then finally, we want to test you on understanding the hiccups. So you have the data. Can you actually tell and pinpoint where the issues are? And so logically, the flow of that blueprint makes a lot of sense to me. And so if you want to check it out, it's out there on our Cisco Learning Network. Check out the ENNA Network Assurance blueprint. And
is that specifically cloud focus or is it just general assurance?
It's general assurance. There's a cloud component to it because it's the core of a network assurance is Thousand Eyes. Right. And so with Thousand Eyes, you have different agents that you can do on your enterprise on-prem, as well as agents at the ISP level and agents in the cloud. And so you can get that entire view. So that there is a cloud component to it as well.
Kareem, we've had this conversation before, but Cisco U has different levels, right? And one of them is free.
Right. So Cisco U has exactly that, three different levels. We have our free, our essential, and our all access. Anybody with a Cisco account, which you can get for free, you can go into u.cisco.com, log in, and see some really good learning free of charge. So we have this tutorial, and this is something that I also wanted to implement as part of Cisco U, which is, I understand that during our day-to-day, our time is limited.
Yeah.
And so if you're looking to learn something, you want to just go do something for like 10 to 30 minutes max, get hands-on, and leave, right? So tutorials are a great resource that you can leverage. We release tutorials almost monthly, covering from basic CCNA and networking all the way to network automation with controllers, right? And so these are free resources. You can go out to Cisco U and check it out. We have a bunch of tutorials to give you a taste of what to expect on the ENCC and ENNA certification. And so we're always aligning free content on Cisco U with our certifications. If you're looking to get more of an investment into Cisco U, we have our Essential, which will give you the fundamental courses and learning path with your subscription. And then All Access would basically not only give you Cisco learning content, but we also bring in content from adjacent technologies to give you kind of a holistic solution and learning from that perspective.
Elephant in the room, AI.
Yeah.
I'm hoping there's going to be a lot of announcements from Cisco this week, but not talking and not putting you on the spot, but where do you see things going, perhaps in your opinion, or is there going to be training on AI, stuff like that?
So everybody's talking about AI.
Yeah.
This is a hot topic. I think we almost went from Bitcoin to AI.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Personally, I think AI is a sidekick to your learning journey, your journey in general. I think we're not there yet with AI, and what I think we think we're further along than we really are.
Yeah, it's only the beginning, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And so when we talk about AI, I always think of it as a tool in my toolbox, right? Where how do I talk to the AI to get it to get some information that he'll basically aggregate all of the learning that it's done to help me?
Yeah.
I code a lot for automation, network automation. And so using AI to auto-complete my documentation, auto-complete my code itself, that's been really, really great value.
Yeah.
Do I think AI is going to take over my job? Absolutely not. I'm not in a million years, because, and you could test it yourself today, right?
Yep.
You could go out there and you can ask AI for, you know, create me the script to do X, Y, and Z.
Yep.
If you don't have the basic knowledge of what's going on and what you, your understanding, AI is gonna dump a bunch of scripts on you. You're gonna look at that and you're gonna be like, oh, this is great. I'm gonna put in my production, and guess what? Don't. And so you gotta understand, and I've tested this. Like, so I was writing, you know, I was building an automation script using Cisco Catalyst Center, and which is formerly known as DNA Center. And I asked it, AI, I was like, hey, can you generate site automation using Python? Give me the script. I want to use the DNAC SDK. And so it did use the DNAC SDK. It did everything right from a syntax perspective for Python, but it did not actually do a site automation and creation. It did an inventory dump.
Oh, wow.
So if I don't understand the APIs, I don't understand the SDK, I'm not going to know whether this is true or not. So it's never going to replace your job. But that's my personal opinion.
But I think it's interesting. Talking to people like you, I hear the same thing over and over again. I spoke to someone recently and he tried to implement AI code into one of his production systems. And
right.
It was like, it got stopped in code review because...
Absolutely.
Yeah. Problems.
Yeah.
So we're not there yet with AI.
No.
It's an enabler and a tool in your toolbox, like you said, but don't trust it. I had simple examples trying to get it to write BGP, ChatGPT trying to get it to write BGP or OSPF, not there.
It's not there. And it might give you the framework or the skeleton that you might use.
Boilerplate.
Boilerplate, yeah, it's a better word. Yeah, absolutely. But it's not, like you said, it's not there. I wouldn't trust it to configure anything from.
Okay, now, personal question. Talk to your younger self, 2024. What would you study or suggest to yourself to study now? Because you did, I mean, you networking background, but you've done a lot of automation, coding. This is another way, I'd say, the AI. Like, start today. What would you do?
I think one of the things that I would pick up, especially if I'm going in the same career, I'm assuming, right, is coding. This is something that fundamental coding, pick your flavor.
Python, right?
Python, Go.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter. Once you understand kind of the logic, you can learn a different language, right? But you know how to put the sentence together. That's the bottom. So learn coding, network fundamentals. Network fundamentals don't go away, right? We talk about the cloud. We talk about expanding to the cloud. Those network fundamentals that you learn from your CCNA do not go away, because you need to take your knowledge and apply it in now at a layer three, right? Maybe the cloud has abstracted layer one and layer two, but layer three is where you start, but you still need to understand these pieces.
Actually, IP addressing, whatever.
Exactly. Actually, if you... If you look at AWS certification, for instance, right, they ask about layer one and layer two in their certification, even though it's not covered in their product, right? So network fundamentals, and Cisco just recently released, we have our CCNA, right? We released our CCST, which is essentially pre-CCNA.
I'm glad about that, Jeff.
Yeah, and this is a new certification that we, for early in career that are looking to get into networking and network automation, that's kind of like the first step that leads you into a CCNA. And so network fundamentals, understand how automation and API works. You know, we've been talking about automation for
long time,
2014, 15 now. And if you see most of our products from a Cisco perspective, it's all about APIs. It's all about connecting the different solutions, right? You're only able to connect the different Cisco products into a solution via those APIs. And so being able to kind of mesh the Cisco solutions to get a better outcome in your network, that's something that is also huge.
But you didn't mention AI. Would you study it?
Maybe prompt engineering, right? Yeah. Make me a better, teach me how to talk to my sidekick. That's prompt engineering, right? How to ask it the right questions at a right level so you can get the best answer out of it. But again, I'm not sure if I'm in the business to write LLM, you know, large language
models,
I'm not sure I would go that far.
I interviewed DJ who was involved in like the ChatGPT type interface on Cisco firewalls. And he broke it up into three places. He said prompt engineering, but that's low hanging fruit. And then APIs is another opportunity. I think someone with your skills, as an example, you know, if you've learned Python, you can interact with those APIs. You can get the AI to do a whole bunch of things. And then you've got like the hardcore AI guys, like data science people. I think there's, you know, someone like, yeah, I look at you and I think, wow, Python networking skills, you could interact with AI now using the APIs and get it to do all kinds of clever things.
Yeah. And if you boil it down, you're not learning something new.
No.
You're just learning a new API, which is the API for that AI, so you can interact with your network. We've done this with chatbots. If you followed, like, you know, back in 2016, 17, chatbots were a thing, right? Like, how do I talk to my network via a chatbot, right? It's a more experienced and more intelligent chatbot. But at the end of the day, from your skill sets, you're looking at it as, this is a new API, a new plugin. How do I use that API with the network APIs to be able to accomplish something? But that's as far for today, as far as AI is concerned, and as far as I would go with AI, I should say.
Kareem, how can people reach out to you? Is it Twitter or X as it's called? What's a good way to reach out to you if they've got questions?
So X or Twitter at Kareem_ISK. Feel free to DM me or ask any questions. A lot of the conversations that we're having, as well as a lot of learning on our Cisco YouTube channel. So if you look for the handle at Cisco YouTube, just head over there. We have plenty of videos from Snack Minutes, from, you know, all of our Cisco U Theater sessions are broadcasted live on there. So check it out and just, you know, follow the advocates from learning and certification. Ask us questions. This is what we do. So, you know.
Snack Minute, you got to tell us about that.
Snack Minute was an idea I came up with back when I was in DevNet. I wanted to give folks in the community a 10-minute bite of learning that basically covers technology, APIs, and some fun, cool demos. And so I hosted with my good friend, Matt DiNapoli, and we basically have different guests on covering technology. And just, you know, I found myself having these conversations a lot with my colleagues, and we're like, you know, I'm sure a lot of people are asking very similar questions.
Yep.
So we created a 10-minute show. We know, like, you don't want to sit there and listen for like hours. So we just put it together, and it's been a fun kind of side project that we do.
Kareem, really want to thank you. Thanks so much for sharing, man. Appreciate it.
I appreciate you. Thanks for having me.